In this video, we will demonstrate how to send structured message in sequence diagram. So we'll take the message with the argument, which is structured. So it has like a parsley, header, payload, checksum, and so on, and we'll send that message. You know, so that means that we can actually construct the message, send the message, receive the message, deconstruct the message, act on that message, you know, and send again. You know. So here we have, from the structure perspective, we have system, we have system A, B, and it has like value, some property, and it references the structured message. You know, it could be value type, it could be block, status message, which has header, message ID, data payload, checksum. It could have, you know, different types, doesn't matter really. It could be integer, boolean, in real. And we have also signal, which has as a attribute, which will get this message as a type. You see, like status message, this one, right? It has this as a type. So now, again, from the sequence perspective, we are just sending this signal. We have the message as a argument name and parameter name in the signal, and the argument is status message, which we will get as an input from this block. As you can see here, system A has status message as a reference, so this property exists. And here in the subsystem A, we can use, you know, like FUML, ALH, active language helper. We can use other methods like swim lanes to form this message. So first of all, actually we are doing like a double work here, but first of all, we are creating object, setting object property values. As you can see, we are creating objects, some random object which does not exist even by name anywhere in the properties. And that's the name of the object which we are going to initialize from the block, right? This is the name of the object. And then we are setting properties of that object, header, message, ID, data, payload, checksum, and then setting this as a status message value. And so that's exactly what's happening here. So let me go here, run this with context, execute, and we'll see, you see like now it's created. So we see this one created this one. You see it gets created and assigned to status message. You'll go back here to status message. This is the reference, right? Status message. And gets those values. So here we have those assigned, right? Assigned. Some of them are strings, some of them are integers, you see, some of them are real. And now it will pass it. So you see, like, status message is the status message, the same property which we have here, also status message. So here we are just saving to that, you know, and passing here. So, like, yeah, and we have some delay here, and this delay is to first of all form the message, right? Then actually send the message, 5 seconds delay or whatever delay you want, like 0.1 millisecond. And then once we get that signal, we receive it and actually parse it and then get the values and act on those values. And then only then we kind of go with the main behavior. This main behavior is in the main system. So if it will finish and everything will finish, so we want to have some delays that this will finish. So here we have this one. See, it gets those values. All the values are received, but only some values we react to, you know, and then get result. Yeah, and this still waits for that. So here is the model, right? So which we introduced to show how the structured message can be constructed, sent in sequence diagram, and decomposed. Actually, we can use the same structured message to send through connector as a signal or as an object, through value properties, multiple ways to send it.